Hello students, today I am going to start fourth module. You can see here the syllabus for the fourth module for CN subject. Here the syllabus is divided into one is wireless network, second one is a cellular internet network. But according to your syllabus, wireless network is not there. That means you need not to study. You need not to study 6.1, 6.2, 6.3. So you have to start from 6.4 for the module 4. So we'll start from 6.4. So the initial session is in this case is cellular internet access, the architecture of cellular and standards, that is example GSM. So what do you mean by GSM? GSM stands for Global System for Mobile Communication. It is a global system for mobile communication. So this cellular network are divided into different generation like 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G. So we will see all those things. So let us start with now cellular internet access architecture. Now the term cellular comes from the fact that every network or every technology, I can say every technology, makes use of its own terminology. So in cellular network, the region or geographical area or the region covered by the cellular network is divided into small area, and in this case it is called as cell. That's why the name came from cellular came. And you can see in the diagram the cell is represented by like hexagonal like this. Now what is there in the cell? What it contains? What is the main function of the cells? You can see in the later sessions. Before that, we will proceed to see what are the different components of the cell. The components of the cells are, first one is a base station. This is the component of the cell, base station. Or we will call this by one more name, base transceiver station. This is base transceiver station. So second one is a mobile users. Mobile users are attached to the base transceiver station through air interface, and which in turn makes all use of physical and data link layer protocols. So first one is a base station, second one is a mobile users, third one is a air interface, you can see here. Now all these cells are connected to mobile switching center, and mobile switching center is in turn connected to public telephone network. Now we have to see one by one the function of base station, mobile users, air interface, all those things one by one. So we'll use our notes. So you can see here, once again the diagram, here this is a cell, cell contains BTS, this is BTS, cell contains BTS, and this is mobile user. So mobile users are connected to the BTS. So by that, mobile user will transmit and receive signal from BTS. So the capability of the BTS depends on various factors. The capability of the BTS depends on various factors. What is that? That we have to see. What is that? So here you can see the capability of the BTS is depend on transmitting power of the BTS. Second one is the transmitting power of the user device. Third one is any obstructing buildings in the cells. Then height of base stations, that is antennas. So all these factors decide the capability of the cell, which in turn depend on the capability of the BTS. So now, this our cellular network architectures are divided into different technology. You can see here, this is the first generation and the second generation, third generation. Now we are using fourth generation, 4G. The first generation was initially designed for voice only. First generation designed for the voice only. Second generation was designed for voice only, but later it was extended to support data. Third generation was designed to support both voice and data. And more emphasis is given on higher speed radio access links. So now we'll see the architecture of 2G network. Now we'll see the architecture of a 2G network. This is the architecture of the 2G network. So here you can see the cells. This is cells, various cells connected to BSC, and BSC is in turn connected to MSC. So we know what is there in various cells. So cell contains BTS, and other than that, cell contains mobile device. Mobile device is connected to BTS. BTS is in turn connected to BSC. BSC is called as base station controller. So now, like this, various cells are connected to BSC, and this entire structure is called as a base station system. So like this type of base station systems are connected to MSC. So MSC can support 5 numbers of BSC. That means MSC can support around 200k subscribers, and this our 2G system makes use of FDM and TDM for the air interface. We know what is FDM, frequency division multiplexing, and we know what is TDM, time division multiplexing. These two technologies are used for the air interfaces. So now, other than that, what are the main jobs, main functions of BSC? The main responsibility of the BSC is providing service to many BTS, allocating radio channels to the mobile users. When you take new connection, allocating radio channels to the mobile users, performing paging, they later you'll see, performing and-off. And-off means when user moves from one area to the other area or one cell to the other cell, the signal should be transmitted smoothly without disturbing the user conversation. That is called as performing handoff of mobile users. So all this done by our BSC. Then BSS we know. Then MSC, Mobile Switching Center, which will connect up to 5 BSC. So MSC can support approximate around 200k subscribers. Other than that, what is the responsibility of the MSC? User authorization and accounting. When you take new connections, the authorization will be done and your account will be maintained by our MSC. Like that, call establishment, call teardown, all this be done, and handoff will also be done by MSC. Like that, there is a special MSC which is called as a gateway MSC. The gateway MSC is connected to the cellular public network. So this is the architecture of the 2G network.